is 100% fiber optics straight through.
And I get $150 back when I switch to Fios.
That's correct.
I got a question.
Is anybody here buying us?
We're in weak, pal.
Switch to Fios now and get $150 back. Unlike cable, Fios can get 100% free fiber optics straight to your home. For HD picture quality that beats cable and customer satisfaction. And crystal clear phone service. Just $79.99 a month with an end-year agreement. An amazing price guaranteed for 2 years. And Fios TV is now available in more Pittsburgh homes. Call 1-877-707-FIOS. Ask about additional packages with over 120 HD channels. Get amazing TV picture quality and unlimited nationwide calling for just $79.99 a month. With an incredible $150 back. Call 1-877-707-FIOS today. This is Fios. This is big.
Your navigation system knows the road less traveled. The road rerouted means another matter. Is your map up to date? Navtech.com.
Whoa, that is one awesome TV.
A free HD TV.
Free HD TV? Cool. Where did you get that?
Roomful Express.
Wait. You're telling me you got a free HD TV from Roomful Express?
You bet.
So, how do I get a free HD TV from Roomful?
Quit talking and you'll miss it. It's the final days of the free Best Buy HD TV giveaway at Roomful Express. Save up to 50% off everything. Plus, we've partnered with Best Buy to bring you free HD TVs. Don't miss free HD TVs now through Sunday.
Accident forgiveness assures you that if you have a claim, your rates won't go up.
Larry Thurgood, Nationwide Insurance.
No one plans to have an accident. They just happen. Accident forgiveness is there for those situations that you don't anticipate and that you may not be able to afford if they occur. And so it's something that gives you that peace of mind.
See John Gable in Latrobe or Patrick Palacy in Pittsburgh and get a quote today.
Minutes Willie's Labor Day sale comes to 7 Spring, Saturday and Sunday only. Ski and snowboard clothing and equipment up to 70% off. Bankers, Waterford, and Foundation. Strong reputation, solid foundation.
Rustler Floors Carpet One, you stand on our good name every day.
Live, local, Blink Radio. Now, broadcasting in high definition.
Danielle Nottingham, the Penguins raise the banner on a championship season as thousands pack Mellon Arena. A crash involving a school bus sends students to the hospital. Today, we know how a red light played a role. And a Pittsburgh Steeler keeps a close eye on the tsunami relief efforts in the South Pacific.
And right now the temperature is 53, mainly clear at 53 in Pittsburgh. Right now wind is out of the southwest at 7, and the relative humidity is 86%, so not a bad morning. A little cool, but other than that, not too bad. Yesterday's rain finally wrapped up. South, it's generally clear. North, it's a little more cloudy. Here's one of the reasons why. You notice that activity heading up over Lake Erie. That is going to stay north, but just north of Pittsburgh. As a point of reference, we'll use Interstate 80 and say that if you get up toward 80, you're liable to see a little more in the way of cloudiness and maybe a couple of raindrops, but not much more than that. South, in the southern counties, including Allegheny County, City of Pittsburgh, mainly sunny clouds, a touch breezy. At times that wind may come up to 20 miles per hour. But other than that, a pretty nice fall day with a high of 68 degrees. More on the weather for the rest of the weekend. It's going to be cooler tomorrow. I'll tell you about that. We'll check the weather for the big football game at Heinz Field tomorrow night. And I'll have my five-day outlook for you. Coming up here, Channel 11 News, Saturday morning continues.
In news developing overnight, a man on Allegheny County's most wanted list is under arrest thanks to the help of a TV viewer. Overnight, sheriff's deputies arrested 24-year-old Miguel Brinson of McKees Rocks. He's accused of sexually assaulting a 16-year-old girl and a 14-year-old girl. Brinson was arrested at his mother's house after someone saw his picture on fugitive files on Comcast. Also overnight, emergency workers are looking for the cause of another fire in Newcastle. This one happened around midnight in a garage along Whiteman Street. Newcastle has seen dozens of arsons this year. It's hockey season again in Pittsburgh. The Stanley Cup champion Penguins return to the ice. They began their title defense against the New York Rangers. Last night started with a pregame ceremony as the team raised its third Stanley Cup banner in front of a sold-out crowd at Mellon Arena. Other fans braved the weather to watch the game outside on the big screen. We asked them what it meant to be. be part of this historic night.
It was pretty electric. It was opening night, and I think there was a lot of hype because of the raising the banner for the Stanley Cup and the presentation and Mario and all the trophies tonight. I think the pregame presentation was really the height of the excitement tonight. And the play on the ice was pretty good, too.
Very good. The Penguins beat the Rangers 3-2 and lost highlights of the game coming up in our next half hour. New information on an accident involving a coal truck and school bus. The crash happened yesterday afternoon along Route 119 in Golston Township, Fayette County. From Chopper 11, you can see the Cotton Bowl school bus slammed against the guardrail. The bus driver was flown to the hospital. Four kids on the bus were not hurt. Police tell us the truck driver was trying to beat a light and collided with the bus. And from the ground, you can see the front of the truck is pretty smashed up. A man working near the intersection describes the scene.
In the tracks, the truck had pushed the bus into the guardrail. So when I saw the students exiting the bus in the rear.
We've also learned the 72-year-old bus driver was released from the hospital and is expected to be okay. A car lands on its roof along Highland Drive in Leamington. It hit a pole and fire hydrant before coming to a stop on the sidewalk. We're still working to find out who was in the car and if they were injured. And there's more discouraging news this morning. If you're looking for work, unemployment figures are at their worst point in more than 25 years. The unemployment rate for September was 9.8%. That's the highest it's been since 1983. A local group is calling attention to the thousands of people who are out of work. Channel 11 News reporter Karen Cepeda has more from downtown Pittsburgh.
We want to be in solidarity.
Fighting for the rights of the unemployed. It's a full-time job for this group. The Mon Valley Unemployment Committee took to the streets just hours after news spread that unemployment in America is nearing the 10% mark. It rose from 9.7 in August to 9.8 in September. And those numbers are faces here.
The hardest thing is not having someone to get up and go every day.
Kelly Parker was a victim's advocate. She's been out of work since July. She comes to the Career Link Center in Allegheny County 3 days a week.
And I formally started working, when I was 14. So I'm 47, so formally I've been working for, 33 years.
This center is working harder than ever. Last month, nearly 2,000 people walked through the door. That's 600 more than this time last year. Workers are feeling the weight of it themselves, trying to help people land jobs and keep the pay.
A lot of them haven't had that experience for numbers of years, so we have to try and explain and talk about the economy and how we're going to help them get back in the labor market. So it's really part of our mission. Yeah, we want to give them hope.
Which is a well-known mission in this group.
This group is rallying for jobs and for extended unemployment coverage. They just asked, who here has a job by show of hands? And almost everybody raised their hand. They say they're totally here to support those who don't.
What really matters is can working people put food on their table? Can new people have access to be able to get good jobs that will allow them to pay the bills? And we're here to remind folks that that's really what the economy is about, and that's what America is about.
Karen Cepeda, Channel 11 News. More than 1,000 women will gather to speak out against violence at the Women's Walk for Peace on the north side this morning. The walk will start in just about 45 minutes, and it will last until 4 o'clock this afternoon. The walk begins at the Northview Heights Bridge and ends at West Park. Channel 11's Kimberly Easton is serving as the group's MC. We're still trying to get new information about a body found under the West End Bridge. The medical examiner was called to the scene yesterday following the discovery. We're still waiting for police to tell us more about the victim and how the body was found. And we're also learning more this morning about a Manessen mother accused of the drowning of her baby. Investigators say 7-month-old Malachi Henderson was left alone in the bathtub and found unresponsive back in September at the family's home. He was taken to Children's Hospital where he died 2 days later. Police say 22-year-old Saria Henderson left Malachi and his 2-year-old sibling alone in the tub while she went outside to smoke and chat with neighbors. During a preliminary hearing, testimony revealed Henderson grabbed her baby, ran downstairs, and screamed for help. Her friends say they responded and witnessed Henderson trying to give Malachi